Riot Games has been around for just about 18 years. It's really famously known for League of Legends. Over the last 5 years, we've launched a number of new games that have really hit it big, including Teamfight Tactics, Valorant. League of Legends is a very kind of fast-paced game that requires low latency to our players. Also, our players are very globally distributed. League being a 15-year-old game means it was kind of born in the era before cloud.
A lot of the challenges that existed with running League of Legends globally have been around data center and local installation that's required to maintain our infrastructure. Valorant was able to kind of break ground in the cloud-based game provisioning solutions for Riot. How do we take Valorant's success and make it something that was easily obtainable by the rest of the games at Riot and future games that were being developed? Performance of games and what those look like over time is actually incredibly important when we want to look at how we best utilize the game server ecosystem. The game provisioning platform, there's a centralized scheduler which allows us to ensure that games get sent to the right game pod for the right game. League is, and also TFT, have a variable aspect to how the game runs. You actually have to ensure that you're scheduling the peaks and valleys in an optimal way to prevent any type of thrash from happening.
We launched a game mode called Swarm, which is a PvE game mode that behaved very differently from our normal League of Legends. That was only possible because we were in AWS and we had auto-scaling. But when we can basically just rent those servers and then give them back, that is a really great experience we could offer to our players. This project of migrating League to the cloud and then auto-scaling our game servers was incredibly successful. We saved as much as $10 million a year.
One of the design principles was that we would eventually get to a place where a game team could bring a game client and a game server and everything else could be handled. We really do believe that this will kind of emancipate games to not have to be concerned about it as much, where a game team could just talk about what experience they wanted their players to have. And that's exciting.